All right, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Today we're going to do a quick tutorial on how to do a quick run cycle for Christmas reindeer. This is a character that I did for one of my adverts on AzurePrince.com, AzurePrinceInc.com. You'll see the link below, and on any social media website of mine at AzureArtInc, at AzurePrinceInc, on Twitter, Facebook, everywhere, or on my website, AzurePrinceInc, INC, Inc is INC, .com. But anyway, let's get started with this quick run cycle that we're going to do. Excuse me. So basically, I've already rigged my character, the turn, and that is what we're going to do. It's going to be running with presents. And so you can come to frame one, turn it to the direction you want it to run, and then hold up presents there, hold up presents there, and then my hands are in switch layer, so I can go down to the switch layer and change the direction. That hand is fine, so we have to look for the left hand. I think it will be at the bottom, and we can change that to, I think this works, it's behind there, it's fine. Excuse me again, I don't know, maybe I'm nervous today. My voice is disappearing on me. Anyway, this is unprepared, this is a freestyle. So what I have is, I have the character, the presents rigged to the back, so when it goes up and down, it's fine. So obviously when you run, you have a lean back. So what we're trying to assess is the first element or the first pose, starting pose. I think when you're running, we're trying to have a different style of running. So we're freestyling. We'll see how many run cycles we can get. And I think this is one common one in the animation industry. They have it like this. It's pretty common in some. And I think I kind of like it. It shows urgency. And we'll edit it and see which one fits perfectly for what we want to do. But I think this works perfectly. And then from here, oh, I've got my voice now. We remove that and go into the other passing pose. So it'll be opposite. So we can switch on onion skin. Go there. Switch on onion skin. And we can switch that up. Let's hope the music is not too loud. Let's just turn that down a bit so you can hear me clearly. 90s R&B. That is the best era of music. Moving on, we go, we align it to the other onion skin. I think that works perfectly. And then, so we have one, two. And then we come here, we bring back this one. Control C, Control V, and we paste it. And so we've got the running cycle. Boom, boom, boom. Action. So we can turn that down to maybe 120. And so 12, 120. There we go. So we've got that. The action, the feet are moving. And then from here, I've got my bones color coded, so this one's going down, this one's going up. So we take the purple, since the purple one is coming, and this will be the one that pushes off. How does that look? Boom. Again, this is freestyle. I haven't even tried it before, this style of running. Normally I do the other style, so we're also just trying to figure out which is the best way to do it. So we'll be in and out, we'll be changing as we go. And then we'll go cycle, and we're gonna cycle back to two, and then we have it repeating. Oh, let's see, that maybe I've got it incorrectly. There, that's better. I had it incorrectly there for a bit. Switch on onion skins again and fix that. And so basically we're just trying to find out the best way to do it, see if we can get it correctly aligned, and that's pretty much about the run cycle. And then, so maybe in a few tries when, you know, since it's a freestyle, we're just going, trying to figure out the best way to do it. And we'll change it, so maybe we'll change that, come back, do what we did originally, turn it, bring that there, and then have the initial pose. This is the initial, and then the second one is the other way. That and that. Those are the contact poses, my initial poses, and then do the same thing we did, control C, and then figure out the passing pose. And it's the purple that goes down, this one goes up, and then the other passing pose. The green coming down, purple going up. Boom, boom, boom. That's better. Bring it back, cycle two. And then we switch off water freeze keyframe. And then from there, we can start editing to make it perfect. And maybe a little bounce, add a bounce, add a perfect contact, and this one, perfect contact again, up a bit, and then it's coming there, slight bounce. Then we can go this tool and we can play with the bounce even more. And then stretch it a bit and stretch it again and see how that looks. And there's a nice little bounce there. And then we can bring that down to make it quicker. And then I think we can take that and we can even add a little lean as we go. Add a little lean, I think forward, maybe. And another one forward.
Yo, Genuine. Make him dance. Dance. Dance.
Well, I think we even exaggerate more. A bit more on the run. We can edit that to there. Add a lot more. A lot more jump there. No. We go. Yeah, I think it's fine. We can add a little more jump there. Or you can do the other way and add when he's actually in the air there as your initial jump. So maybe we can add a new layer. And add a new layer and create the ground. So either way, it's whichever works for you. You can use it, and you can either start with there, have the initial high ground up here, him jumping there, and then coming down to the ground here. Come to the ground there, and then going up there again. I think that one we can use that onion skin and put it there. And we come down again there, and then we take this one again. Initial one, Control C, Control V, paste, cycle again. So that's what it is pretty much about when you're doing a sun cycle. You see what works for you and what doesn't work for you. And yeah, I think that is way, way better. You've got something initially. So add about 240 and we've got our run cycle. Fix that, and then get linear sign, and got our run cycle, perfect. Reindeer running with presence. So we can even make that even faster. Can bring it down to 30. And then make small little edits to make it perfect. Can bring the knee there, little squash and stretch. And then I think when you make contact, you come down instead of actually stretching. You come down and then up, you stretch. You stretch and you come down, you squash. And then you can even increase that by there. We can stretch it, you know. Let's see how that goes, how a little stretch does. And it adds more character to it. A little squash and stretch there. And a little more character, and we have a reindeer run cycle. And then we can delete that, add our pre-made background that I made before, and then there we have him running. And then we can go to the presence layer, find the presence wherever they are, the boxes, there they are. I have the boxes rigged so it's easier to move. So we can come there and then squash them there, move that there, that follows through there, and that's like that there. Control C, Control V, boom, and then there, I think it comes there, and then this one's there, maybe like that, not too much. So, alright, exaggeration is good for animation, exaggeration. So, we have it coming like that, and then we bring it back to the original, see? And then we cycle that back, cycle back to 2, change that to linear, and we have the presence doing their own little thing there. And then, from there, your animation is pretty much done. You have the run cycle there. I think we can even make it faster. So, select, press Alt, and then you drag them back. Let's see what 12 does. That's a little too fast. Bring it to 18. I think 18 works well for us. There we go. And then, so we've got a flowing there. And then what we can do for extra effect, we can come into the file menu, import effects, particle effects. Oh, we can look the other way, particle effects from this side and add snow. And then it's already pre-made, comes with the app, and yeah, snow coming down. And then particle options, and then change that direction whilst it's playing, and you can whatever particle count, increase particles, speed, width, velocity, yeah, and you have snow falling. Then there's your run cycle, running reindeer, delivering presents for Christmas, and then file, and export animation, running Christmas, and then I'm sure you know the formats you save it in, and then export. We're rendering the video, and that's basically your animation done in 18 minutes. But we could have done it in less, considering we redid the first initial run cycle we did. So yeah, that is about it about animating a run cycle for Christmas. So I hope you have a Merry Christmas and enjoy, and I hope I was audible enough this time around. And yeah, subscribe to my channel. We'll be coming up with more videos for 2020 and more animating, more short clips of how to do certain things, how to, yeah, animate. The world of animation will also be trying TV Painted 2020, so we can do better frame by frame animation. And yeah, follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram, visit my website azureprintinc.com. The ink is INC. Thank you. So we're gonna wait for it to render. I forgot about that, so yeah, we'll wait for it to render. It may take a few minutes. And so long, you can listen to the music playing, and I'll be chipping in with comments here and there. And yeah, that's about it. Thank you again. Alright, so we're back again, and it's almost done rendering, and we'll see you see the finished product of our quick animation of how to do a run cycle. And that is our run cycle. And then from here, you can then make edits to change it to what it's going to be. And for me, I feel like the head is supposed to go behind, and my dip sword didn't work very well there, so we're gonna fix that. And then we'll go into there and bring the head. Go back to initial, go there, and then bring the head down to, I mean, just be on the top, it's fine. But as you can see, it's not going down. My dead sword is supposed to work, so probably a bug or something that I'm doing incorrectly there. But my dead sword is supposed to be able to come down to be on the top. Let's see if that works. And there we go, it's behind the top. But it's fine anyway, those are little edits that you can correct out. That is our run cycle. Go to the presence, and that's pretty much it. Thank you again. Remember to subscribe, follow me, and we'll be doing more tutorials on how to do things. I love this character, he's one of my favorite characters. Fan of Rudolph, he's got a Rudolph stuff, and Christmas Day is enjoy.